In part 3 of our lesson on algebraically defined vectors, you will learn how to calculate a dot product. Here, we will let vector u be the vector u1, u2, and vector v will be the vector v1, v2. Then the dot product is vector u dotted with vector v, and notice this is kind of a big dot here. It's bigger than the dot you would normally use for multiplication. Like if you were indicating 5 times 7, you would just use a little dot. This is a bigger dot. This is the dot product of vector u with vector v, and its definition is that that will equal the product of u1 times v1 plus u2 times v2. Now, something to notice here is that this is not a vector. So the dot product of two vectors turns out to be a scalar. You take the two horizontal components and multiply them together. You take the two vertical components and multiply them together, and then you add together those two products. So let's give this one a try here. In this example, we're given that vector A is 4i minus j, and vector B is 3i plus 2j. So you notice that this is in unit vector notation. We could rewrite these, if we want to, into position vector notation. So vector A is equal to the vector 4, negative 1, and vector B is equal to the vector 3, 2. Now to find vector A dotted with vector B, let's look at the rule. We take the horizontal components and multiply them together. So we have to take 4 and 3 and multiply those two together. Then we add to that the product of the vertical components. So we have negative 1 multiplied by 2. Now we simplify. We have 12 minus 2, which is equal to 10. Now just a reminder, we said that the dot product would be a scalar, so this is not a vector. This just has magnitude only, no direction. So when you do the dot product of two vectors, it turns it into a scalar. Next, we will investigate some properties of the dot product. And first, let me give you a conceptual idea. Dot product is to vectors as multiplication is to scalar numbers. So many of the properties that you're familiar with using when you're multiplying scalars, you're going to see also apply to the dot product. So in this first one, vector u dotted with vector v is equal to vector v dotted with vector u. So that's very similar to the commutative property you learned for multiplication. Here, if we have vector u plus vector v, and that's being dotted with vector w, we can distribute that, and it becomes vector u dotted with vector w plus vector v dotted with vector w. The zero vector dotted with vector u is going to equal zero. Remember, this is a scalar. These are vectors. A common error students will make is to have this become a vector, zero, and it can't be. It's just a scalar, just like the result of all dot products. Here, if we have a scalar multiple of a vector, so k times vector u dotted with vector v, we can pull that scalar out and do the dot product of vector u and v first. Or we could do vector u dotted with k times vector v. And vector u dotted with vector u is equal to the magnitude of u squared. So let's try using some of these properties in this next example. We are given that vector A is the vector negative 4, 5, and vector B is the vector 3, 2, and we have to find the dot product of 2 times vector A with vector B. So applying this property here, we see that we can take the constant out, so this would become 2 times vector A dotted with vector B, which is equal to 2 times the quantity. We know to find the dot product, we have to take the horizontal component of A, which is negative 4, times the horizontal component of B, which is 3, and add that to the vertical component of A, which is 5, times the vertical component of B, which is 2. Simplifying, we get 2 times, well, negative 12 plus 10 is equal to negative 2, and finally 2 times negative 2 is negative 4.